It's the Geek again, and I'd like to talk to you a little bit about why you should watch Yo-Kai Apartments. Now, you're wondering, I haven't heard of that anime. That's because it's still new. It's still ongoing, and you should definitely watch it. I enjoy the living hell out of it. It might not be ongoing by the time you see this video. So, I hope that you guys would enjoy it, because it has some great features in it. First off, how do you start off an anime by saying, well, the main character's name is Yushi Inaba, and he's starting high school. How do you start off an anime by having him and his best friend fight under a bridge and knock each other's teeth out? Jesus Christ, that was great. But even better so, how are you gonna start it off by saying, hey, this kid's apartment burned down the day before he goes to school? Actually, no, not apartment. His dorm burned down the day before he goes to school. And now he has to look for an apartment, so he stumbles upon a yokai apartment, which I hope you know what yokai means, because in Japan, yokai can mean anything from ghost to monster to the demon lord of Cthulhu. Yeah, so why is this anime so good? Well, first hint was his apartment, his dorm burns down, and he moves into an apartment full of monsters. Does that sound weird? It sounds weird. I like that idea, though. Because you don't see that in anime too often. No. You get the yokai clan, but you don't get no yokai apartment. So this is a nice new feature that they added in. I've never seen an anime quite like this one. I have some great pointers on why it's good too. Now, Yushi completely falls in love with this apartment because of why, you ask? Let's see now. This apartment is literally the friendliest apartment ever. I wish I could live somewhere like that. The kid literally wakes up every day to demon birds chirping at his window and saying good morning, kinda. So you literally walk down the steps and everyone in the apartment building is greeting you with a happy smile. They have a ghost chef where it's literally just her hands. She's a professional culinary expert, but it's just her hands. And she is an amazing cook. Her food actually makes my mouth water when I'm watching this anime. Now, why does this matter? Because you don't see a strong sense of community in anime lately. Lately it's just blood, gore, killing, violence, more violence, Akame got kill, more violence, and just violence. But why does that matter? Well, Berserk. I love all these new animes, but this one just takes the cake. What is up with this? You're getting to enjoy a sense of community where everybody's friendly toward each other. Oh, and guess what? The kid receives some kind of magical book and he starts training to become a Anmyoji. What is an Anmyoji? That's an exorcist in Japan. You know, those guys that throw the talismans at you? Yeah, all that stuff. But why does this matter? Because its story is still developing. This anime is literally leading up to the point where it's still ongoing, currently ongoing, and it may or may not actually receive another season in the near future, once the season finishes. Now, am I excited for this next season to come out? Yes, I am. Do I love this anime? Yes, I do. Will you love this anime? I sure hope so, because if not, you're gonna hate watching my videos from now on. Alright guys, have a great day, geek out, party on, booyah! Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me, even if it's fake.